So we're going to talk today about why we need vitamin D. Vitamin D has been called the sunshine vitamin. Why is it called the sunshine vitamin? Well, that's the question we're going to ask. So let's get into it. So the three things we're going to discuss really is where vitamin D is from, why we need vitamin D, and as a final point, what happens if you don't have enough vitamin D? Like, what is it really affecting? What does it really affect for with us? So the first thing, where is vitamin D from? Well, as you've probably already guessed, it comes from the sun. That's not entirely accurate. It's our skin that creates it from the UVA, or pardon me, the UVB rays. See, the sun gives us two kinds of radiation, UVA, which ages our skin, and makes people very unhappy and wrinkly and sad and makes them look old. And the other one is UVB. UVB gives us vitamin D. It also burns our skin, and most people like to call that tanning. And that makes people happy. So UVB is great, right? So get more sunshine. Well, the problem is that most people, when they go out into the sun, they don't want that UVA, and so they wear sunscreen. Sunscreen or sun lotion blocks a lot of these rays from getting to us. So we're not getting as much vitamin D in the summer, for example, than we would normally need. So blocking the sun means blocking vitamin D. No sun equals no D. Vitamath 101. So the next, why do we actually need vitamin D? What's so special about it? Well, you probably already know that products like milk and grains and whatnot are fortified with vitamin D. So some expert somewhere in some building thought that we needed more vitamin D and decided to put it in milk because we're missing vitamin D. It's like the lost child on the side of the milk box. We need vitamin D. And the reason we need it is, well, you probably already know that milk is good for your healthy bones and healthy teeth. They say, drink your milk and you'll have strong bones and strong teeth. You've all seen the got milk commercials, right? However, there's new research now that's showing that it's not just teeth that are affected. Sure, calcium and phosphorus are good for our bones, but this new research says that it can also be good for things like the flu or colds, the start of flu season. And other sicknesses, even depression, because it could affect our serotonin levels. And the big one is cancer. We're going to focus mostly on how it affects our things like our colds and the flu. And to start this off, we'll start with a study. There was a study done in a hospital, and it was it was a university study where it said that 57% of the people in this hospital, in general, of all ages, need more vitamin D. They didn't have enough. And they said that was about 200 IU. What's interesting is that's old data. There's been some more recent data which says that an intake of 800 to 1,000 IU is, even over long terms, is closer to what we actually need. So now let's recap here. We need 800 to 1,000 IU of vitamin D. Who really needs this? First of all, people in northern countries. For example, Canada, North America. I know it's not a country. UK and Alaska. Okay, fine. They're not countries, these are just areas. So people who live in northern latitudes need more vitamin D because we just don't get as much sunlight. People with dark skin pigmentation also need more vitamin D. And finally, people with poor nutrition. And this is a lot of people who don't get the adequate nutrition when it comes to obesity and whatnot. Their body just doesn't absorb and use the vitamin D in the way that it's supposed to. So they need more. So we have some options. So one, of course, would be don't use sunscreen. Now, I know what you're thinking. That's crazy. And you're right. That is kind of not really a good option, especially in today's world. We've got the UVA and it ages our skin. The second one is supplementation. So we can supplement there's a variety of ways. We can drink a whole bunch of milk, or We could use a vitamin D supplement, and there's a quite a few options. And we generally recommend you take a supplement of some sort, especially if you're in a northern climate, and especially in the winter. It's interesting, a little side note about winter. You think about it, there's less sunlight in the winter, there's lower immune response, and it's the start of flu season. And these are related. In fact, they found that vitamin D has an effect on our immune system as well. So vitamin D is a really good thing, and so I really encourage you to all to take a look. Try some vitamin D.